Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's close our eyes, open our arms. Now let us surrender ourselves totally and fully to Jesus. Oh Lord, we are nothing without you. Today, as we are participating in this service, oh Lord, take everything what we have. And as humble servants, we surrender before you, Lord. Oh, to Jesus, I surrender whatever I have. Let's sing together with the choir.
All to Jesus I surrender, all to Him I freely give.
Oh, Holy Spirit.
I will labor now and trust Him in His presence daily.
I surrender, Lord.
I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender.
Let's sing together. I surrender, oh Lord.
I surrender.
Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We surrender, Lord, totally and fully to you. We are completely yours. Oh Lord, we need you, nothing else. Totally, as we are, with our weaknesses, with our shortcomings, we surrender ourselves to you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 We surrender ourselves. Take it, oh Lord, this unworthy servant, and bless us and guide us. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Accepting ourselves as we are. We thank you and praise you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, we praise you.
Jesus, we praise
Jesus, we glorify you.
Jesus, we glorify you.
Please be seated. Dear friends in Christ Jesus, today we are going to reflect on a topic that is very, very common to each and every one of us. A duty which is the greatest responsibility of the church as well as the church members. There is nothing. Our duty is to give Jesus to others, to preach the good news to others. This is our greatest responsibility. In the Second Vatican Council, Lumen Gentium, the council strongly affirmed that the church by itself, by its very nature, is missionary. The church by its very nature is a missionary church. And Pope Francis rightly said, if the church does not preach the word of God, the church remains like a babysitter. So if the church has to grow, we should preach the word of God. It is our duty and our responsibility. Saint Paul, in his first letter to Corinthians, chapter 9, verse 16 and 17, very clearly said that I have to preach the word of God. If not, I'll be doomed.
Because I cannot boast of announcing the gospel, I am bound to do it. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
He's telling, I have nothing to be proud of if I preach the word of God, because it is my duty. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have got different duties in our lives, isn't it? So when we do certain duties, we don't feel proud about it. It's my duty. So too, St. Paul says, If I preach the word of God, it is well and good. I have nothing to be proud of. But if I don't preach the word of God, it is woe to me. I will be doomed. Because I am neglecting one of the greatest commandments of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
In the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 28, verse 19, Jesus gave this greatest commandments, this greatest commandment to the apostles, which means to the church. It is nothing, you go and preach the word of God. Let us listen to that.
Go therefore and make disciples from all nations, baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
This is the commandment given to the apostles and to the church. Every church member is ought to preach the word of God, to give Jesus to others. If not, he will have or she will have his own difficulties in their lives. I have seen many people, though they live a virtuous life, they cannot get blessing from God. And the one reason is that they don't give what they have received. They have received Jesus, and if they receive this Jesus and keep for themselves, or if they keep for their own themselves, what happens? They cannot get blessing from heaven. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 So if you have received Jesus, it is our greatest responsibility to share. Dear brothers and sisters, we have got a beautiful narration in the 2 Kings chapter 6, where we see the word of God very clearly says about the preaching the good news. The incident is this way. The king of Syria, Ben-Hadad, he came to attack the kingdom of Samaria. And you know, when the king of Syria, they came and they just were about to attack the land of Samaria, what they did, they just made a big block in the food grain and the water supply to the town of Samaria. And you know, when the water supply and the grain supply is, the food supply is blocked, within a few days there is going to be a big famine in the country, and people will be fed up. When there is no food or no water to drink, automatically what happens, people will be falling to death. And finally, the king has to surrender before the enemy king. And that is normally happens. And the famine was so extreme, so severe, that the incident is narrated. A lady came to the king of Samaria and said, "O Lord, show me mercy and give me justice." The king asked, "What is the problem with you?" Then the lady said, "The other day, me and my friend, we are talking, the famine is so great, and therefore she told me, today we will eat your baby, and after 2 days I will give my baby so that we may eat together." See how the severe is the famine. Mothers are eating their own children for survival. Such was the difficult situation in the land of Samaria. We'll read it, chapter 6, verse 27.
The king answered, "In what way can I help you? If Yahweh does not give you bread, where shall I get it?" "What is the matter?" she answered. "That woman told me, give up your son that we may eat him today, and then we will eat my son tomorrow. So we cooked my son and ate him. But on the next day, when I said to her, take your son that we may eat him, she had hidden him."
Praise the Lord.
Praise
Such
the Lord.
Was the severe famine over there. And finally, what to do? There is no way to get out of this situation. And when you come into the chapter 7 of 2 Kings, we see there were 4 lepers. And they were also very much starving. And they were sitting at the end of the fortress, and they told, "Now, there is no use of being here eating. Because if you stay inside this country, inside this fortress, we will die out of hunger. Better we go to the kingdom of Syria. Sometimes he may show us mercy and he may sometimes help us to live. So let us go there. And thus the four lepers went to the king of to the camp of the king of Syria. And you know what happened? On the previous night, God intervened in the life of Israelites, the Samaritans. What he did, he made a wonderful sound which frightened the troops of Syria. He made them to hear the sounds of horse coming and the chariot running. And the people of the troops of Syria, they thought that the king of Samaria is bringing a huge troop against us to fight. And this what they thought, they out of fear, they ran away from the camps. And when these four lepers, when they came inside, they saw there was nobody. And in all the camps and all the tents, their uniform or food and gold and silver. What they did, they just took it and they owned everything. That is what we see, book of 2 Kings, chapter 7, verse 3 onwards.
Four men were at the city gates, outside, at the other side of the wall. They were lepers. And on that day, they said to one another, "Shall we sit here until we die? If we decide to enter the city, we shall die of hunger. But if we stay here, we die as well. So let us go over to the camp of the Arameans. If they spare our lives, then we live. And if they kill us, then let us die." They arose as it was getting dark to go to the camp of the Arameans. But when they reached the camp, they found no one there. The Lord had let the Arameans hear the noise of chariots and horses, the sound of a great army, and they had thought, "The king of Israel has sent money to the kings of the Hittites and Moshrites to come and attack us." So they fled as it was getting dark to save themselves, abandoning their tents, their horses, and their asses, leaving the camp just as it was. When these lepers reached the camp boundary, they went into tent and they ate and drank. They took the silver, gold, and clothes and hid them there in the ground.
Praise the Lord. So they owned everything. They were so happy because they got such a lot of money and food to eat. But after a moment, the brothers and sisters, they have got a new insight. Let's listen to the verse 9.
Then they thought, "What we are doing is not good.
What we are doing is not good.
Today is the day of good tidings.
This is the day of good tidings.
And if we keep silent until tomorrow,
we shall be guilty.
So let us go and tell this to the king's men."
Yeah. Then,
returning to the city, they called out to the city guards, saying, "We went to the camp of Arameans, but no one was there, not a trace of anyone."
Praise the Lord. So what happened? Knowing this good news, they said, "No, it is not too good to keep it for ourselves. We have to share it with others. If not, we will be doomed to death." And therefore, dear brothers and sisters, they went and told this good news to everybody. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 2, with regard to the birth of Jesus, the shepherds got this news. And the messenger says in this way, "Do not be afraid. I'm going to tell you a happy news, a good news for all generations. That is, the Lord, the Messiah is going to be born." So the good news is that there has been a Savior coming into this world. And that was the good news. And we, the Christians, are the people who have received this good news. And it is our duty and our responsibility to share this good news with others. If not, dear brothers and sisters, we will be guilty of not doing good to others. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, it is our duty and greatest responsibility, this commandment of Jesus, that we have to preach the good news. We can preach the good news through different ways. Maybe either by direct preaching, you can give Jesus to others. Maybe by your life witness, you have to prove that you are a child of God and you should do the mission work. Or maybe helping by financial help, or maybe intercessory prayers, you may be able to spread the news of Jesus. Or maybe by giving and distributing pious articles to the people who have not known Jesus, you are doing a wonderful help. So therefore, make sure this is our duty and responsibility. We are the people who have owned this good news within us. We shall not keep it for ourselves. We should distribute, and let us become the proclaimers of good tidings. Let us stand up. Let us raise the hands up to heaven and thank the Lord. Oh Lord, we are so happy and we are thankful to you, for we have been given the privilege to know the good news that Jesus is the only Savior. Lord, help us to preach this good news, to give this good news to many other people who are around us, through our words, through our deeds, through our charitable acts, through our preaching, and above all, through our life witnessing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Glorify you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh Lord, give us the courage and strength to preach the good news.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah.
Holy Spirit of God, we welcome you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus, we thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, we praise you.
Jesus, we praise you.
We glorify you.
We glorify you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Let's praise and worship the Lord. Our mighty God is here with us. Hallelujah. Lifting the hands up to heaven. Praise and thank the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we praise and thank you. Lord, we need your blessings in abundance. We need your courage and strength. We need your deliverance in our lives. In the name of Jesus, let there all the chains be broken down. Let all the powers of darkness be gone in Jesus' name. Let us praise the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, there is power.
In the name of Jesus, there is power. In
the name of Jesus, there is deliverance, there is healing, there is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain.
Let every chain be broken down in Jesus' name.
To break
and the power of Jesus come down to each and everyone who is watching this service.
To
all those who are attending in their own homes, in their own offices. When they be blessed in Jesus'
there
name, and all the blessed be God in Jesus'
in
name.
In the name of Jesus, there is power. In the name of Jesus,
in Jesus' name, let all the blocks,
there is
all the
problems,
all the sickness be cured
in the name of Jesus.
Lord, let the grace come down,
to
let the anointing increase.
Or
let be blessed, touched by the Holy Spirit.
To break every
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
To break every chain.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We praise
break
the Lord.
Every
hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Let the power of
there
Jesus come down on each and every one of us.
The
Lord, we
Jesus.
Worship and thank and glorify you, Lord. Raise the hands up to heaven. Now God is going to heal you. God is going to touch you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let there be a mighty healing in Jesus' name. Let there be a great anointing in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Let everyone be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus' name, there is deliverance in Jesus' name. Let all the chains be broken down. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
bow our heads. O sacrament.
O holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment done. O sacrament, O holy, divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment now. O sacrament, most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment.
Divine praises.
Blessed be God. Blessed be His holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be His most sacred heart. Blessed be His most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the Great Mother of God, Mary Most Holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and in his saints. Amen.